Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us on our Thanksgiving service. Pretty much everybody online knows the way that we do this. So white letters are leaders speaking, yellow letters. I invite you all to participate. We have readers this morning who are going to read for us some special passages. This is a lectionary order put together by the very Reverend William Mugford, the Dean of San Diego this morning. And it's deliberately meant to give us an idea of Thanksgiving and gratitude. But I want to start this morning having you imagine that we are in the sanctuary and we're just getting an opportunity to look at this Happy Thanksgiving picture, which is, from what I understand, a relatively decent understanding of how this Thanksgiving all came to be, with colonists in New England. And I think that's probably Massasoit, who is the Indian receiving food from the colonists. I did some reading this week and found out that it was mainly men at the first Thanksgiving because many of the women had died in that previous year. So that may mean it's not terribly accurate, but anyway, this is where our roots are. And we're thankful for what God has done over the years and very, very grateful as the people of God for his provision all the time. Israel had lots of these kinds of celebrations during the course of a year. And so it's great that we're able to do that here in our culture as well. I thought we'd begin with a Thanksgiving medley of a few of the songs that are kind of near and dear to our hearts this morning. Here we go. Beautifully bring back some great memories of Thanksgiving's past. And thankfully, giving thanks, it never gets old. We are gathered here in the presence of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We bless and thank you for loving us into your kingdom now and forever. Amen. We gather to worship because, and we always say this, Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Let's pray together to open our hearts for worship. Father, right now, I open my heart, my desires, and my secrets that you may know me. I hide nothing from you. Cleanse my thoughts and intents, undo my stubborn will, and inspire me by your Holy Spirit to more perfectly love you and make your holy name great through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, brother and friend. Amen. Let's pray together a Thanksgiving prayer. Almighty God, we are thankful to be your children, knowing and being known by you. We're grateful for Jesus, his life, his words, his saving grace. And we are blessed by the peace and presence and power of the Holy Spirit in everyday and extraordinary life. So that means we're thankful. I think you're going to love this song. It's new to me and probably new to you too. But look for the really special words that are in the song.
Thankful for the blood that cleans us. Lord, I'm thankful for you. Each day I am thankful. Thankful for the Spirit's leading. Thankful that in you there's healing. Lord, I'm thankful for you. Lord, I am thankful. Thankful for the name of Jesus. Thankful for the blood that cleans us. Lord, I'm thankful for you. Each day I am thankful. Thankful for the Spirit's leading. Thankful that in you there's healing. Lord, I'm thankful for you. Oh, let my spirit soar and worship to your name. My life is not the same by the power of your blood. And every moment that I breathe, your Spirit leads and meets my every need. I'm walking in the light of you. I'm so thankful, thankful for the name of Jesus. Thankful for the blood that cleans us. Lord, I'm thankful for you. Each day I am thankful. Thankful for the Spirit's leading. Thankful that in you there's healing. Lord, I'm thankful for you.
pretty unique, isn't it? All those great Hebrew words and a lot of pictures from the Holy Land, and a picture of Jesus with the writing on his headpiece. Really, really kind of an amazing find on YouTube. Today's scriptures form the basis for our Thanksgiving. So let's open our hearts to hear and be transformed by God's word. So readers, all you have to do is unmute, and we'll start the readings right now with the book of Daniel, chapter 4, verses 34 to 37, which teaches us that humility is always the way to a grateful heart.
At the end of the days, I, Nebuchadnezzar, lifted my eyes to heaven, and my reason returned to me, and I blessed the Most High and praised and honored him who lives forever. For his dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom endures from generation to generation. All the inhabitants of the earth are accounted as nothing, and he does according to his will among the host of heaven. And among the inhabitants of earth, and none can stay his hand or say to him, what have you done? And at the same time, my reason returned to me. And for the glory of my kingdom, my majesty and splendor returned to me. My counselors and my lords sought me, and I was established in my kingdom, and still more greatness was added to me. Now I, Nebuchadnezzar, praise and extol and honor the King of heaven, for all his works are right and his ways are just, and those who walk in pride, he is able to humble. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 118, verses 1 to 9 reminds us gratitude is easy when we experience the steadfast love of God.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever.
Let the house of Aaron say, his steadfast love endures forever.
Let those who fear the Lord say, his steadfast love endures forever.
Out of my distress, I called on the Lord. The Lord answered me and set me free.
The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me?
The Lord is on my side as my helper. I shall look in triumph on those who hate me.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in men.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our second reading this morning, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 12 to 22, Paul tells us why we need to give thanks in every circumstance.
We ask you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves. And we urge you, brothers, admonish the idle. Encourage the faint-hearted. Help the weak. Be patient with them all. See that no one repays anyone evil for evil, but always seeks to do good to one another and to everyone. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit, do not despise prophecies, but test everything, holding fast what is good, abstain from every form of evil. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
You love this song as much as I do.
Let's sing.
gospel this reading this morning is from Luke chapter 22, verses 14 to 20. Jesus shows us the greatest example of a truly thankful life, the holy gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke. Glory to you, Lord Christ. And when the hour came, he reclined at table, and the apostles with him, and he said to them, I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And likewise, the cup, after they had eaten, saying, this cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Just want to share a few moments of meditation this morning on simply what it means to have a grateful heart, or maybe even be a grateful heart. The first passage that we read this morning tells us that a grateful heart starts with humility. Now I, Nebuchadnezzar, praise and extol and honor the King of heaven, for all his works are right and his ways are just, and those who walk in pride he is able to humble. So what's the setting for the passage? Well, Nebuchadnezzar, of course, is king of Babylon. He thinks of himself as the shepherd king. And in ancient Babylonian culture, he had elevated himself to a position of being kind of an incarnation of God himself. So he is the God shepherd king. And God chooses to work with Nebuchadnezzar in order to show him who God really is. And the way that he works with Nebuchadnezzar is that he causes him to go naked in the courts of the king and eat grass. This kind of strange, difficult situation is called boanthropy. And we've actually seen cases of this happen in our world. In the early 1900s, there was a gentleman in England who somehow survived and experienced boanthropy in the very same way that, Nebuchadnezzar did. Well, what's this really all about? If we want to have a grateful heart, we want to try to avoid the kind of heart that's on the screen here, the one that's broken and stitched up and kind of in the firm grasp of something other than itself. And in this particular story, we see the relationship of pride and praise. Nebuchadnezzar is proud of who he is at the beginning. But after his humbling, he prays one of the most beautiful prayers to God, and it closes with those words in verse 37. Nebuchadnezzar moves from pride to praise. If you want to have a truly grateful heart, it's going to have to start with humility. And humility will move you from pride, you know, thinking of yourself first, to praise, thinking of God, thinking of others, and thinking of yourself. The second lesson that we learned this morning is from that beautiful passage in Psalms. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he's good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Well, there's the theme, give thanks to the Lord. Why? For he's good. And the English word good is just simply an expansion of the word God. In other words, God is good is just the very practical way that God shows himself to our world. And why? Because his steadfast love never fails. His steadfast love endures forever. And then there are a list of scriptures. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Let someone else say, and his love endures forever, etc. But why mention Israel at first? Because the word Israel is the name that means he who struggles with God and wins. So what's this passage really about? Well, we all struggle. We all have questions. We sometimes have doubts. Sometimes we're full of anxiety. We wonder, which way is it going to go? We forget that God's already lived in the present, and it's going to be okay. And even if we suffer death through a time here on earth, it's going to be okay, because he's going to take us with him to that heavenly home. So struggle is what Israel did all of its existence, much like struggle is what happens to us all of our existence. Whenever we struggle, we just have to be reminded of God's steadfast love. He cares for us always. There's never a nanosecond that he's not with us, that he doesn't care about us, he doesn't know about our situation. And that could, if you trust it, alleviate the struggle. The third passage this morning. A grateful heart says thanks always. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Really? Give thanks for 2020? Give thanks for COVID-19? Give thanks for all of the things that have happened during this time, the ups and downs of the economy, the election season, which, by the way, still continues. Incredible. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Why is that? Because it puts the focus on God and his sovereignty. So you can stop your screaming. And instead of screaming, start your supplication. Supplication is kind of a fancy word for really deep intercessory prayer. Often supplicative prayer is done kind of like this. Lord, help. I know, it's easier to scream. Does anybody know what's going on? God, do you understand? Why are we in this mess? Yeah, we could scream all day long until we realize that God's already been in the moments ahead of us. He knows what's going to happen and we can trust him. That's his sovereignty, his omniscience, his omnipotence, his omnipresence. He knows. So stop screaming. Start supplicating. Lord, I'm going to stop asking you why and ask you, so Lord, what do you want me to learn through this? At least you'll learn to trust his steadfast love, because it endures forever. And finally, it sinks its roots into Jesus' life. Think about the passage that we just read, and he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, take this and divide it among yourselves. And he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the passage that we read, in some of the opening words, it says that he said all these words knowing that he was about to die. Wow, could Jesus have ever used Paul's words, in every circumstance, give thanks? So Jesus, facing the most difficult time in his life, provides a wonderful example for all of us. He's strong. Sometimes we're really shallow. Could you have done what Jesus did? I mean, clearly, because Jesus is who he is, it's most important that he did what he did for all of us. But he also said to his disciples on one occasion, take up your cross and follow me. You can't follow Jesus if you're a shallow person. Not only because that just doesn't make sense, it's that anyone who truly wants to follow Jesus and become a disciple wants to learn as much as he or she can from the Lord Jesus, wants to learn from that example. How are you there at a Thanksgiving meal, which is what Passover is? How are you there contemplating your death and making it all about God and others? Jesus is pretty amazing when you think about it. He's incredibly strong. So a grateful heart. It starts with humility. It continues in wonderful praise because of God's steadfast love. It asks us to participate in thanksgiving all the time, acknowledging his incredible love for us. And we can have grateful hearts because Jesus has been our amazing example. Don't be shallow. Be strong. Let's pray. Lord, we pray to you today to ask that you might make us some of the most grateful people on earth. Yeah, Lord, that's right, us. The 15 or 20 people that are on the screen this morning, make us the most grateful people on earth. And in so doing, make us a resource to other people who need to learn the wonder of being grateful, the wonder of thanksgiving, based on a God who loves and cares for us. Lord, make this Thanksgiving a special time. If some of us are able to get together with a limited group of people, help us to be the light that shines in the darkness of a world full of ingratitude and conflict. Help us to be that peaceful presence today around the table that calls everyone to acknowledge who God is, his steadfast love that endures forever, and his love and grace for us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Here's a song by Don Moen. Simply says, "Thank you, Lord." You may know it. Sing along.
Bless your name and thank you, Lord. done in our lives, we want to say thank you, Lord.
The prayers of the people, prayers of thanksgiving this morning. I've taken out all of the prayers that we normally pray and just kind of give us an opportunity to say thank you. So everyone on the screens can take a moment, unmute, and say thank you for something. Heavenly Father, thank you for gathering us here this morning to worship, learn, and hear from you. As we pray this morning, help us reach out to you in faith, out loud or in silence, for each one of the concerns on our hearts. Lord, now help us pray from our hearts to you, bringing our thanksgivings, intercessions, and requests out loud to you. And if we have doubts, give us faith to believe you for your answers to our problems. So this morning, let's just make them prayers of thanksgiving. Just simply unmute and give us your thanksgiving, and maybe everybody could participate this morning. We have the time. Let's do it.
I give thanks this morning. I give thanks because I've had my second cataract surgery this past week, a few days ago. I can see so much better. I give thanks to the Lord.
Great.
Lord, I thank you that you're a God who knows us and who wants to be known by us. I thank you for the hope that you give us, even in times when in our society, there's not much hope, but you give us hope, Lord. I'm so thankful for our families, for our friends, for the ability to come together and to worship you. And to, I thank you for your healing. Thank you that you've taken the pain from my knee. Thank you so much, Lord. Praise Amen. And honor and glory is yours this day and always.
Amen.
Lord, I thank you for this wonderful woman that you brought into my life. All the love she brings to our families with all of her skills. Thank you, Lord. God bless.
Lord, I thank you for our congregation. As I've been calling around, it seems that we've all checked on each other and people are taken care of. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, because it's so hard, as most of us are older, to do these things. So, Lord, thanks for blessing me as I have talked to many in our congregation. Thank you, Lord.
Father, I thank you for my family and for my family that's in my house and for my church family. It's absolutely wonderful to have all of you.
Mm.
Amen.
Thank you. Father, I thank you for this church, especially for Rose's wonderful, loving heart. She's always thinking of us, bringing us goodies, thinking about us, and for Father Bill, who just leads us so wonderfully, for his sense of humor, for his love of learning, and his love of God and of us. And Lord, I thank you for the congregation. They are a treasure. They are our friends. And Lord, I ask that you just give us more and more people into our church. And I thank you, Lord, that you have given us a time to live such as this, that we are all able to be lights to the world. Lord, bless all of the pastors. And also, Lord, take good care of Father Keith, Lord, Bishop Keith, we just ask that you give him good health and all the things that you have for him. And thank you, Lord, that you are our good God who lets us live in peace and joy and wonder. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I give thanks and praise for the ability of all of us in this country to live without anxiousness and fear over attending our churches or any other place of worship, that we might be persecuted physically. And I pray too, Lord, that lift up the Jewish people and prevent any further persecution, even in our country, Lord.
Amen.
That they will be a people faithful to you and you to them, Lord. I pray, watch over them. Amen.
Lord, so many things to be thankful for. First of all, thank you for life. Thank you for giving us the life we have. Thank you for placing us in the place where you want us today. Thank you for the many, many things and blessings through our lives. And in this year, Lord, to protect us from COVID-19 and protect us from evil, Father. And thank you so much for hearing our prayers, because we know that we have a God that hears our prayers. Not only that, Lord, but you want to hear from us. You want us to seek you. You want us to be in touch with you and follow you. I thank you for Gail, Jacqueline, Miguel. They are my immediate family. And thank you, Lord, for all the rest of our family. And thank you for this beautiful congregation of Grace Anglican. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father, I just want to thank you for my family, but above all, I want to thank you that you came to my life full of grace, full of love, and made my life full of joy. Thank you so much.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for taking such good care of me, for all my blessings, for this wonderful church, wonderful people, and for making life worth living. I'm so grateful to you. Thank you.
Lord, I just want to say thank you before the whole congregation. I just want to praise you and thank you for your goodness, and that you visit us, that you walk with us, that you found us and you don't let go. I am so grateful with you, Lord, and for the joy that you bring each and every day, even in the midst of troubles. There's this abiding joy that only comes from you. I am so grateful, Lord, for each and every person here, the faithfulness that I see exhibited here. I thank you, Lord, and I embrace every one of us together. Amen.
Amen. Lord, I'm grateful that even though as a retired priest, I'm not able to physically do things like I used to, every single day you bring across guilt in my path, someone that we can love, someone we can get to know, someone we can minister to. And you never fail to do that. I thank you for that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Lord, I'm especially grateful for my family this morning. They're scattered all over the United States today, but and in Canada, and just really grateful for who they are and what they've contributed to my life. Thank you, especially for Rose. And I pray, Lord, that you'll continue to give her grace for every single day. I want to thank you for my colleagues in ministry here at the church. Some of them have positions with names, like Nima, our associate pastor, and JR, who works as our subdeacon, and Jeff Pratt, who's done such a wonderful job helping us over the years with education and music. And Lord, I so want to thank you for the grace that you've given us in Travis and Kelsey and how you're preparing them for ministry at this point. So Lord, thank you so much. Thank you for Jean, our church administrator. She's such a wonderful gift, an amazing gift to us. And for Francis, who helps us do our financial work. And Lord, I thank you for the ministers in our congregation who serve on our vestry, who serve in our altar guild, who serve as prayer ministers, who do all kinds of things in the church. They may seem small, but they're all links in a chain that binds us together. And I want to thank you for them this morning. A special thank you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Finally, Lord, we bring to you other concerns and all of the silent secrets on our hearts. Together, Lord, have mercy and assure our hearts of your love and concern, answering our prayers according to your will, as is best for us. Amen. Bless our prayer ministers, Lord, as they lift us up in prayer daily, and grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Now, let us confess and receive God's forgiveness individually and together as we pray. Most merciful God, I confess that I have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what I have done and by what I have left undone. I have not loved you with my whole heart. I have not loved my neighbors as myself. I am truly sorry, and I humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on me and forgive me, that I may again delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in your great mercy, you've promised forgiveness of sins to all who sincerely repent and with true faith turn to you. So, Lord, have mercy upon us. Pardon us and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you. So you probably don't have a turkey drumstick to knock drumsticks with, but anyway, make sure and give everybody God's peace this morning. We are going to take a few moments and have communion together. And I invite you to just go and find those wafers if they're not already close to your computer so that we can have communion together today. And we'll begin our communion with our confession of faith. And let's do that together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is just and right so to do. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank you for every proud heart you cause to praise you like Nebuchadnezzar, for every struggler that you secured with steadfast love like us, for every scream you turned into supplicative prayer, and for Jesus, whose strength wins our salvation. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever say these words to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, in your tender mercy, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He offered himself and made once for all time a perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. He instituted this remembrance of his passion and death, which he commanded us to continue until he comes again. So now, Father, we ask that you bless and sanctify with your word and Holy Spirit this gift of bread to be for your people that which suffices for both the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night that he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he'd given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup. When he'd given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord and Heavenly Father, with this holy gift of bread, we celebrate the memorial instituted by your beloved Son, remembering his passion and death, his resurrection and ascension, and his promise to come again. So grant that by his merits and death and through faith in his blood, we and your whole church may receive forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion, making us one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And here we offer to you, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a living sacrifice through Jesus Christ, our Lord. For by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away our sins this morning and the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. So take them in remembrance that Christ died for us and feed on him in your hearts by faith. With thanksgiving. So while we listen to this beautiful a cappella piece, O Bountiful Father, let's take our communion together.
O Bountiful Father, my spirit is alone. Do
help me to find a reason to see.
Help
me to find you while your spirit is in need, for in moments like these we need you more.
Oh, Bountiful Father, my spirit is low.
Help me to find a reason to sing. Help me to find you
while your spirit is in need, for in moments like these we need you more.
So revive, revive, revive us again in the great knowledge of a Savior's love.
So revive, revive, revive us again.
Ignite a poor spirit to adore you again.
Though faintly hearted and grieved we may be,
your mercy
mercy still washes the stains of gloom. Inspire me, Jesus, inspire me whole. Let the mountains then sing with me, great is our God. Though faintly hearted and grieved we may be, your mercy still washes the stains of gloom. Inspire me, Jesus, inspire me whole. Let the mountains then sing with me, great is our God. So revive, revive, revive us again in the great knowledge of our Savior's love. So revive, revive, revive us again. Ignite a poor spirit to adore you again. Revive, revive, revive us again in the great knowledge of our Savior's love. So revive, revive, revive us again. Ignite a poor spirit to adore you again.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you for the grace of worshiping together this morning, assembling us in this most holy way, and assuring us that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, help us act on mission. Launch us into the world to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord in the peace and presence and power of the Holy Spirit. Let us share Jesus and do practical works of compassionate love, mercy, and service to bring honor and glory to your name and healing, help, and hope to all we meet, both now and forever. Amen. Hey, please make sure and invite people to come online, especially for this Advent series that we have coming up every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. It'll be a great time together. And look, people are especially open to hearing the gospel right now. So please use your technology and be a witness. Thanks for your worship and generosity. Our tithes, offerings, and almsgiving really do make a difference. I threw this slide in because we were analyzing our finances here coming toward year end. Kind of an interesting pattern, isn't it? We kept ramping up from the beginning of the year, and then suddenly a big spike, and then a way down, and then a big spike, and then a way down, and a big spike, and then a way down. Who knows what's going to happen at the end of November and in December? But we would really love to sort of average above that green line that's on your screen. So would you think about a gift, not only a Thanksgiving gift, but a year-end gift as we approach year-end? Right now, that little red dot on the right shows just below the red line. In other words, we're slightly below what it means to kind of stay even with our expenses. So if we can make this last roughly 5 Sundays a real time of extraordinary giving, let's see if we can knock it out of the park and get above the green line. God bless you as you give. And then make sure that as you're ordering things during this season, check in with Amazon Smile and locate the grace. I always have to remember, Rectors, Wardens, and Vestry of Grace Anglican Church. And if you cite us, they will give us a little portion of everything that you order through them. So please make sure and do that during the season. Let's
praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. And may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Let's connect with our world with grateful hearts for God's love and the peace and presence and power of the Holy Spirit. We are free. Alleluia. In the name of Christ we go. Alleluia. 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 Yeah.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Yeah. Alleluia. How about one more song?
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning, it's time to sing your song again, whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the his holy name. your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Your holy name, worship your